Freedom!
So fresh, so new.
Freedom!
So fresh, so new.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to Family Pride Fridays, hosted by Pride Toronto. My name is Joey. I work for a company called Canvas Arts Action Programs, and today we are here to do some really fun crafts, making some puppets, and hanging out and creating a pride in our own home. Canvas is a Toronto nonprofit, and our vision is to see a world free of transphobia, homophobia, and gender-based violence. And like our name implies, we also love art and puppets. We're going to get to the puppets in a second, but I'd like to introduce a few people as well. Today, we are also joined by Tasha, and in a moment, you'll also see Scout. They'll be interpreting our program for us, and you'll see them signing right over here. Lastly, before we begin, I'd like to do a land acknowledgement. As we've been spending more time than ever in our homes, I've been thinking about what home means for me, specifically that my home is on colonized land. One thing during Pride Month that I have not been proud about is the systemic oppression, hardships, and injustices faced by Indigenous people due to this colonization. I want to challenge folks in this month to be an ally for Indigenous folks. Look up movies or shows produced by Indigenous filmmakers, find art created by Indigenous artists, and look for narratives that are different than the ones that were taught to us in history textbooks. I want to acknowledge the traditional territories of where my home in downtown Toronto resides. These are the traditional territories of the Anishinaabe, the Haudenosaunee, and the Mississaugas of the Credit. Thank you. Let's get into some puppets though. So as I promised, today we are gonna be doing three different crafts. They're gonna range from easy to medium tricky to the hardest. But I think that it's well about time that we start with our easiest one. Today we're gonna be learning how to make shadow puppets. And these are a little bit more complicated than the shadow puppets we grew up with. Maybe you recognize this one, or I know that this was an old fave, but we are gonna be doing something a little bit more complicated. So let's get into it. I'm just gonna pop y'all down right here. So if you see, ooh, too far. Still not enough. So if you see right here, we have a material list. For this craft, you're gonna need some paper. You're gonna need sticks. And when I say sticks, I'm gonna be using something like a chopstick or a skewer. You could use a branch, you could use a broom handle, you could use a rusty old pipe, whatever you want. And lastly, we're gonna need some tape or anything sticky. For the inspiration from my shadow puppets, I'm actually taking inspiration from our Pride flag. In a moment, I'll be showing you all the puppets I created, but I wanna work through one together. So I'm gonna start off working with red. In the Pride flag, red traditionally symbolizes life. So when I'm thinking about life, I'm oftentimes thinking about my heart, I'm thinking about those who I love, I'm thinking about the experiences that I've had as an individual. So I think a beautiful thing to do would be to create a heart. When you're making your shadow puppet, you can do any kind of design. You just gotta be sure that you're able to cut it out. So I'm gonna draw just a really simple heart. I'm so impressed I drew that upside down. The next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab my pair of scissors, make sure they're nice and sharp, and we're gonna cut out this shape that we have. Again, when you're doing your shadow puppets, you can literally make these whatever you can imagine. That's what I love about this craft, is that the possibilities are truly endless. Here we go, cut them out. Once you have your shape cut out, you're almost finished. I did not lie when I said this was a very easy craft to accomplish. The next thing that we're going to want to do is add our stick. So you want to choose an area on your shape that's going to have a lot of strength. So I'm going to go right up the middle, placing my stick down, popping out a piece of tape, ba-ba-boom. It's as easy as that. So now that my shape is attached to my stick, I'm looking at it and I'm realizing maybe I took the easy way out. I feel like I could make this a little bit harder for you. You're all smart folks out there. So what I'm going to do also is, before this actually started, I cut out two smaller hearts as well. And I think it'd be really cute if they were kind of floating right above. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my skewer and using all of my muscles that I've built over quarantine, I'm going to pop it right in half. You're just going to lay these down so you can create a little bridge. Tape down one side and the other. We're going to do the same with the other side. And I just want you to imagine, what would you create if you had to come up with a puppet that resembled life? What kind of shapes would they look like? What color would you use? There's endless possibilities. And just like that, folks, we're all done. So this is a really easy craft. This is a really fun one to do with the younger folks in your family, especially because when you're all finished, you get to create a beautiful show. So here's mine. Woo! Look at it right there. So now that I have my shape all cut out, what you can see is behind me, it's actually going to create a shadow. I want to mention one other thing behind me. I have this beautiful pride flag. So as I said, the red in the pride flag resembles life, but every other color that's in here also has a meaning. I want us to go through a little story together. I hope you join me. Don't go anywhere. We're gonna turn off the lights and get stuff happening. Don't go anywhere. Red is for life. Remember that our lives and the lives of those who we love are valid, beautiful, and changing the world. Orange is for healing. Remember that we are all healing every day when living the life that we need to live. Yellow is for sunshine. And remember that even on the cloudy days, the sun is still shining, waiting to warm our skin again one day. Green is for nature. And remember that nature needs our dedicated allyship now more than ever. Blue is for harmony, and even when the world is loud, remember to listen to the beautiful harmony of community. Purple is for spirit. Let us remember to honor the spirit of so many brave individuals who fought for our rights before we were born, and to honor those who are still fighting for those rights today. Brown is for inclusivity, and to remember that we all have the keys to unlock the chains that hold others down. And lastly, black is for diversity. Now, more than ever, it is important to remember that Pride is a place where not some, but all can be united under these colors. In the words of Marsha P. Johnson, no pride for some of us without liberation for all of us. Oh, I didn't see you there. I'm just doing my laundry. Don't mind me. Oh my goodness. How did those get there? Have you ever noticed that when you're doing your laundry, you always end up with one sock that you just can't find a pair for? I find that a really frustrating thing, but it's also a beautiful opportunity to create a craft. So we're going to be able to, in our next craft, take a sock, a dirty old one that's like this, oh my gosh. And we're going to be able to turn it into a new little friend. Somebody who looks a little like this. How you doing? Oh, how do you smell even worse? So this craft is super simple. The main thing that you're going to need is just a sock. Let's get started though. We're going to pop y'all right down here. Da-da-da-da. Can you see that? Okay. Don't need that anymore because we're working on some sock puppets now. So for this craft, you're just going to need one sock, preferably clean. You're going to need some felt or some paper. A glue gun will help you a lot. I find that you can also use wet glue. It'll just take you a long time to dry it. I wrote paper twice. I'm guessing that it's super important. And lastly, you want some just extra craft things that you might have lying around your house. A beautiful craft thing that I love to use personally is recyclables. So the first step of our craft is we got to create that beautiful little mouth that this person has right here. So if you see on my mouth, I've filled it in with a darker color, so it really makes it super expressive. The way that you find where your mouth should go is you look at where your toes normally rest in a sock, and you're going to find that there's a little seam right there. That's going to be the back of its mouth. So I'm going to take this part right here, and I'm going to take some felt, and what I want to do is cover this area in felt. So what I want to do is first, I'm going to trace it out. So I know exactly where I'm going to be cutting this felt. I'm going to use my little pen right here. Da-da, da-da. Flip it over on the other side. And this is going to be the inside of my puppet's mouth. So now that I have this part right here, I'm just going to use my handy-dandy scissors again. Make sure they're really sharp. If you don't have any felt in your house, it's totally fine to use paper. You could even use paint if you wanted to fill in that part of the sock. Just like that, I have this piece right here. And when I open it up, it's going to look a little bit like an hourglass. Although we got plenty of time to do this craft, I promise. So what I'm going to do next is with some adult supervision, I'm gonna grab my glue gun. Mine's nice and hot, don't touch it. We're gonna add a little bit of glue onto the bottom. Ba-ba-boom. I'm then going to take one part of my sock and lay it down. Just like that. I'm then gonna take a little bit more hot glue and I'm gonna do the other side now. We then take this lip and you're going to fold it up and over. Don't worry about getting this too perfect because once we turn it inside, you won't even see it anymore. So now that I have the front part of my sock all covered, all we got to do next is flip it inside out. So I'm going to push it inside the sock. And just like that, we got a little mouth. Hi. Easy. So now that you have the base of your sock puppet, you can really do whatever you want with it. You could add some big fun eyes. You could give it little hats. You can make some beautiful hair for it. Anything you want. With eyes, let's work with those first. So a very easy way, if you have any googly eyes in your house, you can use those and pop them right there and there, and you're finished. But I don't have any googly eyes personally in my house, so I'm going to show you how I make an eye that looks a little bit like this, okay? So all I do is I grab some very common tin foil. So I'm going to grab, oh my gosh, this is so difficult. Wow, those quarantine muscles. So I'm going to grab just a section like this and crumple it up into a ball. And you want to get it nice and tight. You're going to end up with something that looks like this. The next thing that I'm going to do, I'm using felt, but you could also use something like paper. I'm going to wrap my eye in this felt. So I'm just going to take it like that, move it around a bit. And using my glue gun again, I'm going to put a little bit of glue in there so I can fold all the sections down. Just folding them down. Where did I put my scissors? Oh, they're there. So once you keep on folding it down, I have a lot of extra, so I'm just going to trim it away. Don't be too afraid of the back of the eye looking a little bit messy. We don't worry too much about that. I'm out of glue sticks. Luckily, I got one in my pocket. Ba-da-boom. And we're just going to keep on folding it down so that eye starts to be entirely covered. I found another good way to make eyes is if you use the tops of a milk container or even a jar lid can work. So now I end up with this thing that looks like a little bit like a spooky ghost. Because it's scaring me, I'm just going to chop off this end grate here. There we go. And we have an eye. Off camera, I made a second one. So now we're all set to give our little friend some googly eyes. When you're placing your eyes, there's no wrong place to put them. You just want to make sure that the heel of your sock is going to be the top of its head. So I'm going to pop down a little bit more of that hot glue. Remember that if you're using hot glue, you should have some supervision if you're younger and you're not experienced using the hot glue, because you can give yourself a pretty nasty burn. You've got to be very careful. So now my puppet has some eyes. It's easy as that. I think that my puppet would also appreciate being able to see, though. So I'm going to take a little bit of extra felt that I have. Again, you could use construction paper. You could use paint to paint on your eyes. But I'm just going to cut them out two little pupils. There goes one. Right there. And I'm going to add on another one. Just like that. Now my puppet can see, and it can see all of you. It makes it happy. I think that my puppet now is looking pretty good, but I think it would love some hair. So to make a puppet's hair, what I'm gonna use is just some regular old tissue paper. Something like this. You probably have some laying around from maybe your last birthday or the last time that you had to wrap a gift. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a few strands of it. So I'm just cutting this lengthwise so I get a nice long strip of hair. Wow. They're going to have really long hair. I'm excited. So what I'm going to do is take one strand and we're gonna start building their beautiful head of hair. I'm just gonna pop a little bit of glue down and place down the ribbon. So again, you could use construction paper for this. You could even use newspaper or some string would be really beautiful. The possibilities are truly endless when making a sock puppet. And my favorite part about a sock puppet is that it's a really easy craft, but they look so fun and so silly. I'm just gonna add another one down. Beautiful. I love its hair. I think it's looking gorgeous. So you can continue to add more and more things onto your puppets. What I really love about this guy right here is he has a little pair of teeth. So I think I'm also going to make a pair of teeth for mine. How to make a pair of teeth, or actually we also have some paint. We could make a tongue too. So how to make a pair of teeth is you just want to draw out a shape that kind of looks like two little tiny hills. You can add as many as you want to make as many teeth as you like. You're then gonna pull out your trusted pair of scissors and just cut around them. If you do a tiny little fold, just like that, you'll have an area to place some glue on. Again, if you're using hot glue, I really recommend having somebody around who is a hot glue expert. I say that as I put glue on my finger. So that is a rule. Do not do this unsupervised. We're going to add some little teeth in. Look at that. It's all ready for the dentist. So let's try him on and see how he looks. Whoa. Pretty cute. I love him. I think he looks really, really fun. So sock puppets are a really cool way to create a new little friend that you can have hanging out in your house. I think if I were to continue to work on my puppet, I might give him a few more hairs because right now it's looking a little thin, but I still think that they look beautiful. The best part about sock puppets, especially during Pride, is they can be beautiful singers. They can sing like almost any one of your favorite songs. As long as you know the words, they do too. And they're probably a little bit better singers than us too. So I'm really happy about that because you don't want to hear me sing. I think that maybe, would you be willing to do a little show for us? Yeah. Are you gonna go get ready for a second? Okay. I'm gonna leave them to go get set up, but I'm really excited. I think they're gonna do a show for us. So remember that when you're creating your own Pride puppets, they can put on spectacular performances for your parents, for your family members, for your siblings, and for your loved ones. But, oh, is that, are you all ready? You ready over there? Okay. Here we go. I want to welcome to the stage Miss Frutilla DeLoom.
Pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets, the traffic starts jumping. Folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living. And it's getting by. It's all taking and no giving. They just use your mind and they never give you credit. Service and devotion, you would think that I would deserve a fair promotion. Want to move ahead, but the boss won't seem to let me. I swear sometimes that burning out is getting me. You're just a step on the boss man's ladder to cute light dreams he'll never take away. I'll say vote with a lot of your friends, but for the day your ship will come in and the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna roll your way. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living. And it gets in by, it's all taking and no giving. Just use your mind and you never get the credit. It's enough to drive you crazy as you let it. 9 to 5, yeah, they've got you where they want you. And you're better alive if you think about it, don't you? It's a rich man's game. No matter what they call it, and you spend your life putting money in your wallet.
Wow, what a beautiful performance that was. So gorgeous. Frutilla, that was amazing. I was so inspired when I saw you performing that I decided that I'd make my own hair. I know that the hair salons have been closed for a while, but I think that this is a pretty good look. Let's call Frutilla over and see how they think it looks. Frutilla, come on over. What do you think? Whoa, Frutilla, ow, that's my hair. Ow. Sorry, folks, 1 second. We're having a puppet catastrophe over here. Oh, Frutilla, get back here with my wig. That cost me good tinfoil. Frutilla, you mean puppet. Sorry about that, friends. That puppet, always stealing my things. So, I actually, when I was running around the house, I found one of my other friends. Their name's Flower, and they were slithering around, and I think that they want to join in the fun. Flower, where are you? Flower, do you want to come out and say hi? Although I think they're a little bit shy. Flower, come on out and say hi to all the people. It's Pride. Oh, here they come. Look it. Can you see the camera? There's all of our friends. Oh, here they come. Hi, Flower. Flower is one of my favorite puppets, and they're actually really big. I think Flower might be as tall as I am. So Flower is a very large puppet. And if you're looking at this and thinking, wow, that's a really hard craft to do, I promise that it's not that difficult, and we're going to work through it together. But maybe, Flower, do you want to sing a song for us? Do you want to do a performance? Oh, no? Why not? You were talking all day about how you wanted to sing for us. Oh, no. What's wrong? It's Pride, though. You should be happy. Do you want to tell me something? Oh. Flower's a little bit nervous to perform for everyone. Would it be more helpful if maybe you had a friend? Yeah. Oh, yeah, I think that you enjoy that. Okay, well, why don't we make you a friend, Flower, and then will you do a beautiful duet for all the people watching us today? Okay, we're going to let you go then. We're going to work on a very large puppet. Okay, slither on away, Flower. There you go. Nice. So, Flower's a large puppet, one that you actually use your entire hand to move. So this is going to be our last and our most trickiest puppet to make today. But I promise that we're going to walk you through every step of the way. So let's get started. So to make a large puppet, we're going to need a few more things than normal. We got to have cardboard, an old shirt. I know that during quarantine, I've gone through my closet and I've found so many things that I don't need anymore. that maybe you found also an old shirt. It might have a rip, it might have a stain. That's not garbage, it's craft material. We're also gonna need some plastic bags or anything to fill our puppet with. We're really gonna wanna have a glue gun for this portion, so you might also wanna grab an adult who can help you out with this craft. Again, I'm using felt, and I'm also using paper. And I'm using extra craft things. If you noticed on flower, they were very colorful. I used paint on their scales and pom-poms. So if you have something like that hanging around, go for it. And if you don't, you can still make this craft. So let's start off with the cardboard. We're gonna need a large piece of cardboard. And lucky for you, I had pizza last night. I didn't eat it all by myself, I promise. So the first thing that we're gonna wanna do when working on our large puppet is we're gonna want to create the mouth. That's what we're gonna be using the cardboard for. So I'm gonna use my pen and I'm going to draw something that looks like a giant lima bean. Could be a pinto bean, but definitely not a chickpea. We want it to be long and wide, just like that. And because we have the magic of television today, I'm not gonna cut this out myself because I've already done it, but we are going to open up this box and see what we have inside. So if you look here, I have my shape. This is what you want your shape to look like. See? Garbanzo bean? No, it does look like a pinto bean though. So we wanna cut out a shape like this. You're also gonna wanna cut out one long rectangle that can fit along the length of your bean shape. Oh my goodness, how embarrassing. I didn't finish all my pizza from last night. Actually, one second, folks, I haven't had lunch yet. Nobody saw anything. So, now that we have our large shape, what I've done is I've folded it down the middle. So now it makes a little hill shape, half of a circle. You're gonna wanna take your long rectangle shape that we've made, and we're gonna attach it on two sides to make a handle. So this can be a little bit tricky. Again, you're gonna wanna find maybe some adult supervision for this craft, but I feel confident that you can all figure it out. So I've bent it up a little bit and I'm gonna tape it so it creates a little tiny handle, just like that. I'm gonna use my glue gun, pop some glue down right there, pop a little bit on the other side, and we're groovy. Just gotta hold it for 1, 2, 3 seconds. And when you now use this, you're gonna put your fingers inside that little slot right there, and you can use it to control your mouth. It's not wanting to stick. I didn't wait long enough, impatient. So now that we have the mouth of our animal, we're gonna need the body. So on the body that I used for flower, I used a lot of yellow fabric. But I think for flower's friend, I found this really old shirt in my house that I'm never gonna wear again. It says it's for a squash championship. I don't even play squash. I don't know how I have this. So what we're gonna do now is using the bottom side of our shirt. So the part that rests around your belt or your waist, it should be the largest opening in your shirt. We're gonna use this to wrap around the lips or the mouth of our monster. This can be a little bit tricky, but what you wanna do is just lay it flat. Again, grab your glue gun. Oh, I got some confetti on it. And we're gonna pipe some glue right along that edge. Grab the seam and gently just start to place it down. So I'm gonna keep on going around this entire edge right here. So this is really simple, but you wanna make sure that you're not getting your fingers burnt. If you have an adult, again, just make them do it. They can stand the burns a lot better than we can. So I'm gonna keep on going this entire way all around this edge. right here until this is entirely sealed shut. But to save us a little bit of time, we've already done that. So we're going to pull out this guy right here. So if you see here, I've glued this fabric all the way around the edge of the mouth. Now when I put my hand in the head hole, I can control my puppet. See? So we have the start of a little puppet right here. But we're still missing a few parts. This doesn't really look like anything quite yet. So I think the first thing that we got to do, though, is probably fill him up. Yeah. Oftentimes when people make stuffed animals, they'll use a type of material called batting. It looks a little bit like cotton candy. If you don't have that in your house, though, totally fine. We have alternatives. What I love filling a stuffed animal with is just regular plastic bags. If you're like me, you have at least 7 closets full to the top of these plastic bags. So this is a great opportunity to use some of them up. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start to stuff my little character right here. So I'm putting some right up at the top. If you run out of plastic bags, you can also use an old pillowcase. You're going in there too now. If you run out of pillowcases, you can use some old Halloween decorations. They're going in. So we just want to keep on filling this up with stuff. And then it'll start to take shape. I think mine needs a little bit more. Running out of things. You could use, maybe not. This is too important. Don't use toilet paper. We're going to need it. So I'm just going to keep on filling up my animal. And now, when I put my hand inside, I'm going to feel around for that handle we made earlier. And voila, we have a little creature. You can see here's its head, but it's not looking like it's going many places fast right now, is it? Probably because we're missing a few important things. So just like how I made the eyes of my sock puppet, I made a few more. So these are just the same kind of tin foil as before. And I'm going to pop them right on top of my little guy. So you can place your eyes wherever you want. I'm just going to stick them on right here. Anywhere works. Boom. Now we can see. And look at, just like that, your puppet becomes alive. And now that I see that it can see me, I want to start to decorate them even more. Create a gorgeous little friend for you to have in your home. Somebody who can hang out with you this Pride. You can tell them your secrets. You can share stories. Maybe they can teach you a little bit about yourself. If I look inside of his mouth, it looks like he needs a little bit of dental work. It's looking a little gingivitis-y. So I want to fill this in too. What I've done is I just took some regular paper and I cut them into these shapes right here. And I'm going to use it to pop those right down and fill in the mouth. So let's do that right now. I got to trim this one. It's a little bit big. That. Put some glue down. Whoa. And voila, easy as that. I've made something that was brown into an even different color of brown. Oh no, its eye fell off. Ah, don't look. Traumatic. We need an ambulance, here we go. If an eye falls off, not the end of the world. That's why we have hot glue. So I'm gonna stick that eye right on there. So it's looking a lot better now. But I still think that he might want some teeth. So we're going to add a few teeth in. Similarly to how I did with my sock puppet, I'm just going to cut out tiny little shapes that look like this. It looks like a marshmallow that sat on a really hot surface, melted a little bit. I'm going to create a little tiny fold on the one end, so it creates a little L shape, attach a bit of glue. Ba-ba-boom. And voila. I have a baby newborn sitting on my kitchen table. My baby's first tooth. I'm so proud. You can continue to add really fun things to these puppets. I think another really cool thing to always add to a puppet is a big tongue. Tongues are really funny, especially because they flop around inside the mouth. So when I'm making a tongue, I'm just going to grab, you could either use pink construction paper. I'm using a piece of pink felt that I have left over. And I'm just going to cut out a long tongue shape. What I love about these puppets, when I was making them, I didn't go to the store once to buy anything. I started to look around my house for things that maybe I didn't need anymore, or maybe things that were going to end up in the garbage can. And I grabbed all those and was able to make these really fun friends. So I encourage everybody, if you're doing any kind of craft, always try and look around your house for something that can be reused. I'm just going to pop that right on there. And look, he has a little tongue, just like that. My baby's got one tooth and one tongue and two eyes. So we're doing good. You can continue to decorate your creature. We could add paint to him. We could add even some arms or some legs. But let's see how they look right now. So I'm going to put my hand inside, grabbing the lid again, and look. Wow. So I'm going to keep on working on this for 1 second, but as we move forward, here we go. Let's pop this screen right back up. Hi again. So, in that moment, I finished off my puppet. He's grown a few more teeth. I've added a little bit of a longer tongue and some eyes. He's looking really cool. So, now that we actually have a friend for Flower, I think that it might be ready to do our last song for the day. Does that sound good to you? Yeah. Okay, we'll be back in 1 second. Don't go anywhere.
I'm
Wow, what a performance that was. So, oh gosh, I'm attacked. So I hope that you're going to take some inspiration from me and my friends that you saw hanging out today. Isn't that right, Flower? Yeah. I hope that everybody has a beautiful Pride Month, and that if you're feeling a little bit lonely or left out, because this year we can't hang out in person as a community, I hope that you create some friends and some maybe new family members that can hang out and spend a beautiful Pride with you at home. From me and Tasha and Scout and everybody at Pride Toronto and Canvas Arts Action Programs, I want to wish everybody a beautiful, fun, and safe Pride this year, and I hope that you all have a lovely time. We'll see you around soon.